Imagine creating a custom AI assistant in less than 5 minutes without writing a single line of code. Flowwise just released a game-changing feature that lets you do exactly that. Gone are the days of complex chat flows and endless node configurations. I'm about to show you how to build powerful AI assistants with just a few clicks. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create an AI assistant that can access your knowledge base. It has access to tools, as well as custom tools that you create, and you can integrate it anywhere, like websites, APIs, or just as a standalone app. Everything happens on a single screen. Let me show you how this works. Update your Flowwise instance to the latest version or greater, which should be 2.2.2. Then go to Assistants, and you should now see this custom assistant card. By clicking on this card, you can see all the different custom assistants that you've created today. Let's create a new custom assistant and let's give it a name. Then let's click on Add to add this assistant. Now, instead of having to add a whole bunch of nodes to a canvas, we simply follow the steps on the screen. Let's select the model from any of these providers. For this demo, I'll use Chat OpenAI. Now we can add some system instructions for this assistant, or we can use Generate to assist us with writing the system prompt, and we will get back to that in a second. We can also add a knowledge base to this assistant by clicking on this drop down, and now we can select from any of the knowledge bases within our document stores. I'm going to select this demo store, which contains some information about Apple's financial statements. And now we can enter a useful description of the knowledge base, and this will help our assistant to determine when to reach out to this knowledge base. So let's enter something like, this returns information from Apple's financial statements. Then, based on the LLM provider that we selected, we need to specify our credentials, as well as the model name. I'll change this to GPT-4o. We can also set the temperature. We can enable streaming. We can also specify the maximum amount of tokens that the responses are allowed to take up, and a whole bunch of other properties related to this agent. We can also allow image uploads if we are using a multimodal LLM. And if we have image uploads enabled, we can also specify the image resolution that should be applied. I'll simply disable allow images. And before we move on to tools, let's save this assistant. When we scroll back to the top, we can see this preview window where we can start interacting with our assistant. I'll enter something like, hi. And we do get our response back, confirming that our connection to the LLM provider was successful. Let's ask a question from the knowledge base, like, what was Apple's revenue in 2023? And we get our response back along with the citations, confirming that the knowledge base was indeed used. Another useful feature is that we can use our large language model to assist us with generating our system instructions. So under system instructions, we can click on generate, and this gives us a few templates to select from, or we can just enter our very own prompt. Like, this assistant is called Tom and responds in a friendly manner, including emojis. Tom has access to a knowledge base containing information about Apple's financial statement, along with some other useful tools. Now we can click on Generate, and this will use our LLM to flesh out this prompt and greatly improve the responses that we can expect from our model. We can do the same thing with the knowledge base, by the way. In the knowledge base description, we can click on Generate, and that will rephrase my description to make it even better. Finally, let's move on to tools. I want my agent to be able to go online to perform research for me. So what I can do is click on Add Tool. Then in the tool dropdown, we get a list of predefined tools that our agent can access. But what's really impressive is we're not limited to the predefined list of tools either. If we created our own tools, so if we go to this tools section, and if you're not familiar with this tools menu, this allows us to create our very own custom tools. And these tools are also available to our assistants. So let's go back to assistants, custom assistants, and if we click on tools, we can also select custom tool. And in this dropdown, we have access to all of our custom tools as well. But for this demo, I'm going to add web search to my assistant. And for this, I'll use SERP API, and I'll select my SERP API credentials. Now let's save the assistant. And in the chat, let's ask something like, what is the latest news on AI? AI. And we get this response back, which doesn't look all that good in dark mode. So switching over to light mode, we can indeed see all of these responses. And we also get our sources. And we can click on read more to access the original article directly. Now that we have our assistant up and running, we can greatly improve the assistant by going to settings, configuration, and from here we can add things like rate limiting, we can add starter prompts, follow-up prompts, we can even enable text-to-speech, we can enable things like chat feedback, we can analyze this assistant by enabling something like LangChain, we can also collect lead information from the conversation, and we can also upload files as well. Now this is all good, but how do we access this assistant from outside of Flowwise? And I'm glad you asked. We can click on this API endpoint button, and this will give you several different integrations that you can perform with this assistant. We can embed this assistant into any website using this embed API. We also get sample code for integrating this assistant using Python or JavaScript, or we can see the entire API using this curl menu. Or if we really feel lazy, we can simply go to share chatbot. We can make it public. Let's give it a name, like my assistant. Let's scroll down to the bottom and save this. And now all we have to do is copy this URL and open it in our browser. So if you are using Flowwise Cloud, or if you have your own instance running in the cloud, you can share this with anyone in the world and they'll be able to access your assistant. If you would like to learn how to deploy Flowwise to the cloud without worrying about dealing with infrastructure and scaling, then check out this video over here. I'll see you in the next one.